What's something that people don't understand until they experience themselves? Aging. Oh, we were so foolish in our youth. I did not believe your back could actually hurt. Migraines. Hear so many people not believe they are real bad until they get one themselves. Vertigo. No, it's not just mildly annoying. You feel like you're free falling and it just doesn't stop. Abusive parents. The amount of times I've been told they love you. They have your best interests at heart is unreal. But it's simply because they can't fathom the opposite. Chronic pain. The mom's L4-L5 disintegrated into her sciatica over a decade ago. It took everything from her, including the respect she previously had from her friends and loved ones. Nobody understood. Depression and in particular suicidal ideation. Grief. I never knew what to say to someone going through it before I truly experienced it. And still, it is tough coming up with correct wording. A friend once told me, "There's nothing I can say or do to make you feel better. But I will be here for you." And that was real AF, and I think the perfect thing to say to someone grieving are anyways. PTSD flashbacks. It's not like a memory in the slightest, it's like you are actually there. They affect everything that you do, from getting shopping or dropping your kids off at school. The seductive rush of performing in a band to a full venue of people really digging your music. Death of a spouse. Poverty. The invisibility and shame of being homeless. Obsessive compulsive disorder. Not being a neat freak. The real thing. And I wouldn't want anyone to experience it. Not only is it distressing and debilitating, which most people can have a basic idea of, but what no one ever mentions is that until you're diagnosed with it, you think you're literally going mad, which is not pleasant. Depression. People think it's just a bad mood and shrug it off, thinking it can be overcome by discipline and willpower. Being the patient. I've worked in healthcare about half my life. I've always remained calm in some crazy situations. 3.5 weeks ago, I literally knocked on death's door. It not only was a different perspective, but I now have a totally different outlook on my life. War. Addiction. Life under a dictatorship. People who lived their whole life in a democratic country have no idea how truly lucky they are. Gonna give a strange one. Seasickness. That shit really hit different for people. Some people feel like dying throughout it, whilst others are sick for a day and then completely fine after for the rest of the trip. Trauma. It changes your entire life. The scars no one can see hurt a hell of a lot more than those they can. Being in a non-abusive relationship. When you are in a toxic relationship, it seems normal. Then you find someone who truly loves you and it's like, oh wow, so this is what real love is like. Being overstimulated. My mom never took the time to try and understand how it works and what she can do to avoid overstimulating me. In her mind, I use it as an excuse to not talk to her or to avoid interaction. Most people who don't experience it don't understand that when you say I'm overstimulated, you really mean I can't think properly because of how many things are in my brain. I can't talk to you. Look at anything too bright. Or listen to anything too loud. I need to go into my room and not exist for a few hours so my brain can sort itself back out. LSD. Being a first responder. People think it's like in the movies, TV series. But it's quite different from that. Being as broke gets, and being homeless, being called rich by your relatives and friends. Shitty mental health. So many negatives here, I have to balance it out. Seeing a mountain, like a real mountain, up close. It's humbling to see something so massive just right there. Really helps you appreciate how big open space is. Post-traumatic stress disorder. I mean real PTSD. Changes nearly everything about you as a person and how you view and respond to life. It's nice to think that there's some finish line to healing from trauma, and for a lot of people, there is. But when you have real PTSD, the finish line doesn't exist. It causes brain damage, nervous system damage, and impacts your mental well-being for the rest of your life. It's not something you heal from. It's something you have to learn to live with. Really shitty and hard for anyone to understand who doesn't live with it. Driving from one hospital to another. Leaving your possibly dying wife behind to try and catch the ambulance carrying your possibly dying child. Edit, I should say that they are both alive and healthy now. How detrimental debt can be and how easy it can be to fall into. Seriously. It can take just one missed paycheck to need to use some form of debt or credit service. As you're now paying more for the same item or service. It can be harder to clear. The more debt needed to keep serving, the worse it gets. And very quickly, it can become unmanageable. I know richer people and people from fairly well-off backgrounds who say people should live within their means and shouldn't get into debt in the first place. But it's just not that easy. Miscarriage, smiling face with tear. Death of a parent. Marrying the wrong partner. You don't understand what it really means until you do it. I don't think people understand what it's like to be a minority that's generally looked down upon. There's just a thousand cuts to your self-confidence and happiness. A difficult breakup. I'd seen people go through them but didn't understand how gut-wrenching they could be until I went through one. Men generally never understand the amount of harassment women experience on a daily basis. Maybe they gasp some of it if they really listen to what women around them say. But might not fully understand because they generally don't experience it. Fatigue. I have MS and can tell you I was not expecting how hardcore it is. It's like pulling the plug. And your body just wants to shut down. Not sure I saw this in here, but failure. The kind of failure where you put your heart and soul into something but despite that things don't work out. My dad always says things happen for a reason, and this has been generally true in my life, but that moment you know you have failed to achieve something you wanted to, no matter how little, is a sinking feeling. Senior parents. People don't take the time to understand they can't hear. And generally communication by humans is poor. Not looking at someone when speaking to them. Volume or inflection trailing off. Talking too fast for the person to understand. It's difficult to experience. The senior wants to be involved. But then people discount them because of the perceived inability. Migraine pain. It's absolutely not just a headache. Having to leave a cheating partner. It's easy to judge those that stay but don't understand how extremely hard and painful it is to leave despite the betrayal. Police abuse. Like, people can kinda understand it. But you don't really get it until you're held at gunpoint for no reason by someone who you know would face absolutely zero consequences if they pulled the trigger. With others standing by watching. Or even supporting them. The people who, in theory, are supposed to protect you just being completely indifferent to whether you live or die. Almost everything. You can have a lot of knowledge of things. But wisdom only comes through experience.